What's up, guys? Casey here with Max Aroma, your number one destination for fragrances on the low. Now, today we have our review of our four men's fragrances from the second part of our La Rive collection. So this is not any new fragrances that La Rive has released, just new fragrances that we are reviewing for men's collection of La Rive. Now, we had Aqua from La Rive. We had Brave. We had Cabana, and we had Hitfire as well. So Hitfire being the Dior Fahrenheit clone, we have Cabana being the Jean Paul Gaultier Le Male clone, Aqua being the Aqua di Gio, the original by Armani clone, not the Profumo. And La Rive Brave being the Invictus, Paco Rabanne Invictus clone. Now, I've tested these fragrances out over the span of about 12 hours each. So in the 48 hour span that we usually do our reviews for a single fragrance, I've chopped it up into four segments. So in the daytime, I wore the lighter fragrances, and in the nighttime, I wore the more denser, or at least fragrances that I expected them to be a little denser in terms of the body of the fragrance from the notes and the overall expectations I had from the original, where this is a clone. Now, in terms of the two first fragrances, so in the daytime, I tried Aqua and Brave. Both of them, they provided a range of 3 to 4 hours in terms of peak performance, meaning you can smell the fragrance, from time to time when you get whiffs of it. But in overall length, I would say I wore it from 8 to 4, which is my work time, and in the office. And I would probably say I smelled it maybe 60 to 75% of the time. So about 6 hours is fairly pushing the fragrances. I wouldn't say it lasted me up till 4, obviously. So 6 hours is what I would expect from these two fragrances. And something to consider is that it is the winter time. Well, at least in Texas, it's not really winter, but still. We had about 50 degrees to 60 degrees for the past 2 days. So these fragrances are usually more of a summertime or springtime fragrance. So they may vary in terms of longevity, but they definitely will not be pushing the 6 hour limit I would set for these fragrances. In terms of projection, I would say definitely not arm's length, probably body. It sits very close to the body. So maybe about half a feet would be as much as pushing it for the projection of these. Now, in terms of the scents, the scents were about 60% accurate in terms of what they were trying to portray of the originals. I wouldn't say they're as good even for the 60%. The Aqua had a much more alcoholic note in the introduction, in the top notes, and in the first 30 minutes of me trying the fragrance out, it was quite strong of an alcoholic note, so it was a little nauseating in the first 30 minutes, but I did spray like 3 on my neck, so that's something to consider. I tried to push the fragrance as far as possible in terms of longevity and projection, so I did overspray a little. Something to keep in mind if you're trying these fragrances out. In terms of recommended use, I would probably say, as I made the recommendation in the first impressions, poolside, beach club. So if you're going into a beach club, these are perfect fragrances. Nothing too crazy. You're gonna get splashed around. You don't want to be wearing something expensive like the originals maybe, or just something Creed or Armani or any Bleu de Chanel, anything you'd be wearing at a beach club. I would not be wearing it, or Allure Homme Sport, any of them. I would not be wearing those at a beach club. These are perfect to get that same kind of scent, but for a very bargain price. And in terms of office, I definitely liked it for the office because I felt like the notes were nice, the scent wasn't overbearing, and I wasn't getting distracted in terms of what I was smelling all the time. It was pretty consistent and linear. Now, for the two darker, or I'd say denser fragrances, for the Hitfire, I wasn't too much of a fan of the fragrance notes. I didn't see it really mimicking too much. It did have 60% of that DNA of Dior Fahrenheit, but I didn't enjoy the fragrance in terms of how it was portrayed and how it developed over time. I got about 3-4 hours of max performance, so I didn't get really too much performance on either of the, or actually the Cabana I got more than that. I'm sorry, the Cabana I got about 6 hours, and this one I got around 4 hours of performance. So the Cabana I was very satisfied with. I definitely liked the sweetness to it. It definitely had the Jean Paul Gaultier notes. I can tell 65%, I'd say, in terms of mimicking the fragrance. And for Cabana, Hitfire though was a miss. It was definitely not a hit for me. I'd say about 55% was the accuracy of the cloning effect that they had for the La Rive fragrance house. In terms of the performance, as I said, 4 hours of max performance, meaning in between you can get around three hours of peak performance where you can smell the fragrance. You can, you know, actually perceive that the fragrance is there, not just the skin scent. In terms of projection, I would say probably for all of these fragrances altogether, they sit close to the body, you know, half a feet of projection maximum. Unless they are sprayed onto your clothes or they're lingering onto your clothes, then don't expect them to be projecting massively. Now, for the usage of the Hitfire and the Cabana kind of variants of the these La Rive clones, I would say these fragrances are best for maybe like a bar night. You know, if you want a casual bar night, you're going to the pub nearby, dive bar, whatever, these would be pretty cool to have on you. They're nothing crazy, nothing fancy, but they definitely have a nice scent, pleasant, nothing too crazy, as I said. In terms of seasonal use, these are, just like the originals, are best suited for fall, winter. I would not recommend these worn in a different kind of season, because they are still reflecting the originals, and the originals are more of a fall, winter season, and the overall body of the fragrance has more sweeter and muskier notes, so that's something to consider when you're trying to wear. That's all that we have for the men's collection of La Rive. So these are not new releases, as I mentioned. These are just new additions that we have to review. These are wonderful fragrances for the office, poolside, beach, club scenario, beach club scenario, not the club, beach club scenario, or even just the beach. I'd say dive bar, pubs are pretty suitable as well for a casual get together with any kind of friends you have. And office-wise as well, these are very nicely suited for the office, just for a inoffensive kind of fragrance on the low that you'd like to be wearing at the office. These are perfect as well. That's all that we have for these La Rive men's collection. Make sure to check out our November giveaway as well, as we are still having it open for people to enter. So if you'd like a chance to win a free fragrance, make sure to check that out. We'll see you next week for our La Rive's women collection we'll be trying out. Let it go. Let my body go. Take our bodies higher.